everyone, it's Hailey, and today I'm going to be talking about my January TBR. So Bookmas is now over, but I still have my decorations up, and I probably will for the next few videos because I'm pre-filming a bunch of stuff for when my sisters come home, so then I will be able to have a little bit of a break after going crazy with filming and editing for all of Bookmas. But in the last video of Bookmas, I talked about my New Year's resolutions and what I'm hoping for 2019, specifically with reading, and a big theme of that was the fact that I wanted to fall in love with reading again. So this month is the first one where I'm going to really try and do that, and I have some books here that I'm very excited about, and I'm also going to really try and follow my TBRs very well, which is something I've never done. I have never been the kind of person to set my TBR and then that's exactly what I read. I always just kind of talk about things that I'm interested in, but I kind of want to use my monthly TBRs as kind of a checklist. So I have my handy dandy rainbow reading journal and planner here from Stella Bookish Art. I will link the Etsy page where you can get this down below. I love this thing, and this is my first month of being able to use it, so I've got my TBR in here, and then I will be able to put my haul and the number of pages I read on every day. It's going to be so helpful. So in that resolutions video, I also mentioned that I wanted to get back to doing my TBR challenges, so we'll start with those books. So I'm kind of getting rid of the challenge of reading a classic every month because as much as I want to, I don't want to be rushing through classics, so I'm going to nix that one and just do the other challenges that I had. So first I have a new release from the previous month, but I'm also going to allow myself to use this one as a new release from the previous year or just an old release that I haven't been able to get to. So for this challenge, I'm hoping to read The Light Between Worlds by Laura E. Weymouth. I particularly want to read this one because I'm kind of unsure about it. It's very intriguing to me. It's kind of about what happens to the characters who go to Narnia after they go to Narnia and then they come back. So that seems like a recipe for success, but I'm also not sure about it and I haven't heard too many things about it. So I definitely want to give this one a go and see if I'll like it. And if not, I'm going to DNF it because that's what I'm going to start doing this year. I'm going to be a savage and DNF books if I'm not liking them. Next is a new release from the current month, and there's a couple, but the number one that I will be getting to is King of Scars by Leigh Bardugo. So I have a little chapter sampler here that I got when I went to Book Expo this year, and I haven't read it yet. I like to just have it for like collection purposes, but I'm so excited for this book. I just don't like reading chapter samplers because then I'm like, okay, I want the rest now, but I will soon have the rest in my hands. It's coming out at the end of January, so I'll be reading it at the tail end of the month. But oh my god, I can't wait, and I for sure will be picking it up the second it shows up on my doorstep. But if you guys don't know, this is Leigh Bardugo's next novel set in the Grisha universe, and it is following Nikolai, and I'm so excited. Nikolai, I never know how to say it. Oh well. The point is, he's my favorite character, and we also have Nina in here, and then I'm sure we're gonna be introduced to some new characters. I just can't wait. I actually meant to start with this, but if I don't end up finishing my current read, which is Skyward by Brandon Sanderson, which I should finish, but if I don't finish it by the end of this week, then I will definitely be reading this in January. But getting back on track, next is a new release for the next month. So if I have any arcs for the next month or the month after or whatever, that's basically what this slot is for. So I actually have three here. I have two from February and then one from March. So the one from March is Once in Future by Amy Rose Capetta and Cori McCarthy. And this is actually a retelling of King Arthur, I believe. Yes, yeah, so it's King Arthur as you've never imagined, a bold, fearless adventure about a diverse group of rebels fighting to save our galaxy from tyranny. I didn't even realize that this was going to be sci-fi. But it is gender-bent King Arthur, which is amazing, and it is coming out sometime in March. It doesn't actually... March 26th. There we go. But obviously, I will try and prioritize the February releases that I have first. So I have The Afterward by E.K. Johnston, which is about a group of lady knights, which sounds amazing. Or Four Dead Queens by Astrid, which I don't even really know what this one is about. It just kind of reminded me of some other YA fantasies, so I was like, sure, we'll give it a go. But like I said, even for arcs, if I'm not feeling it, I'm gonna DNF it. And the last TBR challenge, but I do still have some more books to talk about after this one, but the last challenge is to read a sequel, and I have a couple here that I would like to prioritize. So first I have The Defiant by Lesley Livingston, which this one is probably the one that I should try and pay attention to first because I already pre-ordered the next book in the series, and that is coming out on Valentine's Day, I believe. So if I do read this in January, I'll still be on track to read the sequel right when it comes out. But this is the sequel to The Valiant by Lesley Livingston, which I read when it first came out a couple of years ago now. I don't don't even know, but I really enjoyed it, so I don't know why I've put off the sequel for so long. And next is The Reluctant Queen by Sarah Beth Durst. This is kind of a similar situation where there's actually another book out that I already own, and I found out that they're coming out with another book, even though I thought the series was supposed to be over. I was very wrong, but since I already have the next book, I feel like I just really need to read this, especially because it has been an entire year, and this would be a great audiobook to listen to because I really enjoyed the first book on audio. I lied, that actually wasn't the last challenge. The last challenge is A TBR Veteran, which is a book that has been on my TBR pile forever, and I have so many, as you guys know, but I'm going to try and prioritize Stolen Songbird by Danielle L. Jensen because this one has pretty high reviews on Goodreads, so I kind of want to start off my year with a bang with some books that I'll really enjoy, and this I know is about goblins and stuff, so that's unlike anything I've ever read before, and I feel like it has a lot of potential to be something I would like. And the final two books on my TBR are just random books, so I really would like to get to a lot of my historical fiction because I love reading that in winter, and winter is going to be gone before I even know it, so I'd like to start in January by reading some. So the one I have on my TBR is The Game of Hope by Sandra Gulland, although there are so many others that I would like to get to. This one is the one that I'm going to try and prioritize because it came out pretty recently, so I feel like it would be a good one to start off with, but this is about Napoleon's daughter at the time of the French Revolution, and she's an artist, and everything about it just sounds very intriguing and unique to me. But if all goes well, I should be able to read a little bit more historical fiction, which would be awesome. And the final book I'm planning on reading is the first book that I want to read in 2019, because every single year since I started doing my top 10 lists of the year, the first book that I've read in that year has ended up on this list. It was true of 2018, 2016, 2017, all of those years, so I want to keep that streak going, and there's a lot of pressure for it, so I'm planning on starting off on a book that I have heard nothing but good things about. Everyone seems to love it, and everyone wants me to read it, so that book is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn, Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. I'm going into this not knowing anything, just knowing that it has an insane amount of hype surrounding it, and I'm hoping that won't be to my detriment, but I think I'm going to physically read it rather than do the audiobook, although I've heard good things about both of them, but I really hope this doesn't disappoint me because that would just be tragic in so many ways, but I guess we'll see. So those are all the books on my official January TBR. I'm hoping that I will actually be able to stick to that list because that would be awesome. I've never done that before, so it will be an interesting experiment. But I'll be happy if I can get to at least 5 of these books because then I will be on track for my reading goal for the year, and that will be great. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please let me know what is on your January TBR, and don't forget to click that subscribe button and then click that bell icon so you'll be notified whenever I post. I post new videos every Wednesday and Friday. You can also follow me on all of my social media, all of my handles and links and all of that stuff will be down below for you guys. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!